And welcome to it. And it was a major development earlier today that Baltimore City withdrew its condemnation action against the Maryland Jockey Club and the Stronach Group, which means, and it has everything to do with the future of Pimlico Race Course and the future of the Preakness Stakes here in Baltimore. So right out of the gate, I thought it was worthy to have on an attorney for the Maryland Jockey Club, Alan Rifkin, who has joined us before to discuss this matter and this development today. And Mr. Rifkin, thank you so much for joining us.
Our pleasure, Brett. Always a pleasure to be with you.
So what happened today in, as far as this development for to do exactly as you said to do months ago, that the city withdraw this lawsuit against the Stronach Group?
Well, the mayor, and we compliment the mayor, always have complimented him. This lawsuit was begun, as you know, under a prior administration. And I think upon a fresh look at it, this mayor decided, and rightly so, that instead of confrontation, that a spirit of cooperation and good faith negotiations may prove more beneficial. And he's right.
Were there any conversations between the city and the Jockey Club prior to today's announcement that led to this? Was there something specific that said, all right, let's let pragmatism take root here, let's let cooler heads prevail, so to speak?
Well, I think it was evolving. And then fortuitously at the Preakness, Belinda Stronach, who is the CEO and the president of the Stronach Group, and the mayor had an opportunity to talk to each other. And sometimes when you see each other face to face, it breaks the ice. It did here. And the city solicitor and I have been having conversations off and on for the past month or so, suggesting that it's better to discuss how to resolve a problem than to litigate it. And I'd said to the city solicitor many times, and he appreciated this fact, that what do you really get by attempting to confiscate another person's property other than more animosity and more rancor and less likelihood of success? And if the goal here is to rehabilitate and renovate these aging, sprawling, capital-intensive racing facilities, and to do so in a manner that enhances them and maintains those facilities for the future and for racing and for the Preakness, then what you want to do is sit down, discuss that problem, identify the challenges, and then try to resolve them. And I'm delighted today, really am, that cooler heads prevailed, and we can now wipe the slate clean and see if we can find a resolution. It's not going to be easy, but we're going to certainly try.
We're talking with Alan Rifkin, the managing partner at Rifkin Wiener Livingston, talking about his representation of the Maryland Jockey Club, in this case the Stronachs, who now that lawsuit has been withdrawn by the city. So what is the next step in this process, Alan?
Well, I think I think what's going to happen next is the city solicitor and I are going to talk in the next day or so and try to identify what would be and who would be necessary for the initial discussion of the needs. You know, there are two ways to look at this problem, and there always are when you're talking about capital facilities of this magnitude. The first is you look at it and you say, well, what do you need in order to make those facilities workable for year-round sustainable racing and to maintain the Preakness in the city? That's one way to look at it, and that's a good way. Another way is to say, well, how much in the way of resources are potentially available, and how far will they stretch? So we have to have that first conversation, but I think that's going to be an easier conversation than the next steps, which are, okay, how do you solve the problem? Where do you come up with the resources? And what do you want these facilities to look like going forward? And can you afford to do it?
Would you say, Alan, that everything is still on the table to start these negotiations? Or maybe they're not in the eyes of the Jockey Club, that it could still be a two-track solution. It still could be racing at Pimlico only a couple of weeks of the year, really revolving around those 2 days that still do extraordinarily well. Or is it still the all-or-nothing approach? And I'm sure it still comes down to money and where that comes from. But is the Jockey Club still open to anything within reason?
Well, I think that's right. And there's been some misunderstanding about that over time. The Jockey Club's position is, and the slate's now been wiped clean for those who may see it otherwise, to all options. The end of the day, the state has two racing facilities. They are sprawling and capital intensive, and we're open. The Jockey Club is open to maintaining them both, but to do that is a challenge, and we have to be practical and pragmatic enough to realize that it is a challenge. You know, you don't have two baseball stadiums, you don't have two football stadiums. If it's optimal to maintain two racetracks, then we have to have a clear understanding amongst all of us. How is that funded? How are those facilities to be addressed? And how are they to be operated in a way that's sustainable? But yes, all those options are on the table. And I have to say, the historical legacy of the Preakness in Baltimore is not something we discard lightly and don't want to discard. So it's heavy on our minds to see if we can make this work. It always has been, but the challenge has been resources. So let's hope we can find those resources. Let's cooperate in a way that puts everything on the table to make that happen. We'll do our part. You can be assured of that. And I know the mayor will do his part. And then hopefully the state will find a way to join us in this this significant effort.
I was going to ask, that was my next question, what is the role of the state here, the governor and the Maryland Stadium Authority? As we know, they had the multi-phase study that they released that everyone kind of chipped in on. What is the role of these entities from the governor to the MSA when it comes to the next phase of these negotiations?
Well, we hope they participate. We expect that they will participate, and there's good reason for them to participate. You know, racing in the state of Maryland is not just centric to Baltimore City. It's a statewide industry. It employs thousands of people statewide. Horse farms dot the Maryland landscape in a way that we're all very proud about. There are racetracks in various states, various counties and jurisdictions. It's a statewide economic issue. It's a statewide development issue. And the state has always taken a very keen interest in the racing industry. So we would hope and suspect that the state will again assist our efforts. And we look forward to that.
Okay. Well, Alan Rifkin, interesting development today with the city withdrawing their lawsuit against the Maryland Jockey Club after that has been going on now for some time, including through Triple Crown season, the Preakness Stakes. But an interesting development today indeed. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure.